radio mode.
No, what did it say?
It's covered in snow.
Oh, is it? Yeah, it's so quiet.
But it was actually Ulysses S. Grant that signed Yellowstone into being the world's first national park.
It's a video.
It was quite the foresight they had in... Set aside this land for future generations. Luckily, the truck up ahead of me stopped, so I can blame it on them, right?
Yeah.
But yeah, that's one big bull out there. They're all staying there. See how he's chasing that one?
Yeah.
He wants them all to stay there because there's a guy, we might see him up the road here. He's been hanging out kind of close. He's quite a bit smaller than this big bull. But he's been bugling and singing his love song, trying to lure some of these ladies away. He's going crazy. And this big bull is being very vigilant, trying to make sure none of these ladies... It's not enough to have one, two... We've kind of been learning as we've gone along as stewards of this park, what works and what doesn't work. We've made a lot of mistakes along the way. Especially when it's this cold. But on the far end, you can see some bubbling hot water. Well, not so much this morning. On that far end there's some bubbling, boiling hot water that's pouring up into that big old pond there. We'll talk about the thermal features. And when I... It's off to the left here. There's a little pool there, and then right out of the mountain there, you see that steam shooting out. That's a fumarole. A fumarole is just a steam vent, and we're going to see a number of, maybe all of this thermal activity we have is one of the reasons that the volcano doesn't go off more than it does. I don't know. They're definitely related. And ultimately it joins up with the Missouri River. Now once it joins the Missouri River, it does go through a series of dams. But from the Absaroka Mountain Range to where it joins up with the Missouri River is 661 miles. They've been, our central herd has been hanging out here in the Hayden Valley, but now that the weather's changing, they're migrating a little bit. They, during the summer months, they kind of come up into the higher elevations, and they spend a lot of time here in the Hayden Valley, and then they start migrating toward lower elevations where they can still get to grass. I can't believe people are in this big a hurry, right? Oh well, get around us, man. We're taking our time. But anyway, they're on the move a little bit, so they are changing locations, but I have a feeling we will see some up here.
I saw them there, up there, the hill.
Yep.
It's a picture-perfect day. You know, today is one of the, really one of the last days of the season that we're going to be able to do a full lower loop like this. Yeah, that's exactly. The males are just really interesting. Okay, now the little calves are born in April and May, and as late as early June. And the little calves have had the whole summer with just mom and the ladies in the herd.
You hear them? They're like bubbling. Yeah. Blah, 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 blah.
Will one?
I'm getting ice.
A little bit.
That's what an earthquake sounds like. When there's like a loud earthquake. It's like...
He doesn't want to talk to me anymore. Okay.
It's a learned hunting technique.
Sweet, guys, how cool is that?
You see him, dude?
Yeah,
under the
of course.
Oh, yeah, he has a mouse.
He's got something in his mouth, doesn't he?
Yeah.
He's looking at us.
He's walking away.
He's got lunch and off he goes, right? Or they blend into their environment well, don't they?
They do.
Yep, there you go.
He wasn't moving, you couldn't see him.
Now he's moving pretty good, isn't he? It's a good sized coyote.
We did this.
I can guarantee we saw a red fox in town,
and it was definitely not. Now, guys, which stabilizes our riverbanks, that helped with our nesting areas for our waterfowls. The balance of Yellowstone came back.
And he's gone.
But yeah, it is kind of funny that they make such a high squealy sound.
Yeah, because it looks so
But they're
like
so big and massive.
Tough. They look all like muscly and like
right?
And you get up and scream like a little girl.
I've never even thought of that, but you're exactly right. That's hilarious. Look at this little island out here. One little tree on that little island. And also, they'll have a real accurate time on when Old Faithful is going to go. But I'm thinking if we're there at least by 2 o'clock, we should be pretty close to... And we should be there easily by probably 20 to 2.
It's crazy.
Crazy. Is this your favorite?
My favorite what?
Your favorite jam? Got your favorite colors in here? This one's a video.
Oh, okay.
But we can also do a picture, wait. Say cheese.
Cheese.
Okay, the flash doesn't work when it's recording video. Cheese.
It's so blue.
Right?
You want to loop around or go back?
No, wait, I'm taking a video. now he's up.
That's too much fun right there. Is that everybody?
Yes.
All right.
There you go. A little bit. I don't know how they can swim in this lake. It's so cold. Got himself a fish. Yeah. pretty wild, like, the setting. When we have a chance to stop, you see all the mountains that were behind us.